Okay, friends, so fun times. I don't know if you can tell by my voice right now, but I am sick. I have gotten a cold for my children, who all had a cold last week. However, today is Sunday and Thursday is Thanksgiving. I want to have Thanksgiving, so I'm still going to be making Thanksgiving. However, I'm just not really sure how filming's gonna go for this. It's Sunday though. I really planned nothing for Thanksgiving, but I also know that I have my plans from previous years, so I just kind of have to write everything down, make a grocery list, and send Mr. Firefly to the store. He's actually already at the store picking up a few things for me now, so it's working out, but I haven't made a list. But he was just like at the store and he was like, hey, do you need cranberries? Cause I know Thanksgiving's coming up. And I was like, yes, cranberries would be great. He's like, what else do you need? I'm like, I have no idea. I haven't made a list yet. And he's like, what about sweet potatoes? And I was like, yeah, I need those too. He's like, how many? I'm like, I don't know. I haven't looked at my recipe yet. And he's like, well, like one bag, two bags. I'm like, I'm not looking at them. I don't know how many are in a bag. And I was like, do you know that purple casserole dish we have? I need enough to fill up that if I was making mashed sweet potatoes. And he's like, I got you. And I was like, I know you do, because he's great. Okay. Anyways, I'm going to sit down now with my recipes and make a list and make a schedule. And we're going to do this. Okay. Also, I am not going to film on Thanksgiving this year. I have filmed on Thanksgiving in previous years. This year, I am only going to film the Thanksgiving prep. And that's because I just want to sit and enjoy Thanksgiving this year, especially after not feeling so hot, at least at this part in the week. But I am anticipating feeling better by Thursday. That's the plan. Plans we make always work. Okay, so yes, let's start planning. So I started out by grabbing this blue folder. I just keep a ton of different random recipes in here that haven't made it into my binder yet, or some that may never make it in. I've had this folder for probably 15 years now. It's a great folder. There's a lot of memories in here. All right, but what I'm doing is I'm going through and pulling out anything Thanksgiving related that I can find. I know that I have at least some, if not all, of my Thanksgiving recipes in here. And as I was digging through, I did discover that I had all of my Thanksgiving recipes. So that was fun. And I'm just pulling out anything Thanksgiving related so that I can kind of go from there with my planning. All right, I got my stack here and I am good to go. I was especially happy to find even things like the cream of mushroom soup recipe, so I didn't have to like go back and find that on old video. And then I found a menu from possibly last year or the year before. So that was really exciting. So I'm just gonna use that to make my menu from this year, because I really just use the same menu pretty much every single year. My menu is very basic, very traditional. I'm definitely a traditionalist when it comes to Thanksgiving. It pretty much has to be just like Thanksgiving at grandma's house. Okay, so we've got turkey and stuffing and gravy, which hopefully my mom will make this year because I don't really make gravy. I wrote down rolls and put a question mark by it because I may or may not bake rolls this week, but if I do, that would be nice. What else do I have? Sweet potato souffle. That one's a little bit different than like the marshmallow sweet potatoes that my grandma made, but this sweet potato souffle is delicious and not overly sweet. Green bean casserole, because you gotta have the green bean casserole. And sausage cornbread stuffing is my own addition to our traditions. And then I just skipped down a little bit to write kind of the snacks and desserts. So I'm making Chex Mix per request of Mr. Firefly and tradition of grandma, and pumpkin pie because my dad really likes pumpkin pie, and Buckeyes because that is another old tradition that I might have made up, but it's still my grandma's recipe. All right, so I'm just kind of double checking over things and making sure that I have everything that I want. I know I skipped a few things that were on the menu there from that whatever year that other paper was from. Oh, and I remembered cranberry sauce, because you gotta have cranberry sauce. And now I should be pretty much good to go. So here is the menu for Thanksgiving this year. Okay, and while you guys look at the menu, I'm gonna continue with my planning. The turkey. All right, how long will the turkey take to cook? I look this up every year, I never remember. So first thing I'm gonna do is just come in here and find out how big my turkey is. And then I'll know how long to cook it, because I will look it up on Google, because that is the only way that I know how to cook a turkey. Okay, it's going to take 4 hours to cook my turkey based on the size and the fact that it is a stuffed turkey, or will be a stuffed turkey once I stuff it. Okay, now I'm just pulling all of my recipes out and making sure that I have a recipe for everything. I found a couple things where I had two recipes, so I'm kind of comparing the two recipes, and there are slight differences, so I am picking one and throwing the other away. As I was looking for the Buckeyes recipe, I did find another Thanksgiving menu. Only when I looked at it a little closer, I saw that it was our Thanksgiving menu from last year when we did Campsgiving. So this food had nothing to do with what we're doing this year. I did, however, find the Buckeyes recipe labeled as peanut butter bonbons. All right, so now I have all of my recipes. By the way, if you would like to see our Campsgiving adventure from last year or any of the previous Thanksgiving videos that I have made, there are quite a few at this point, I will link to those all in the description box below. Okay, what I'm working on right now is a little schedule of what work I'm going to be doing for Thanksgiving throughout the week. So I don't want to do everything on Thursday, and some things actually require prep work the day before. So I just want to do as much as I can really this week during the week so that I don't have as much to do on Thursday, because it's, you know, it's Thanksgiving Day. I'm going to have a baby. I'm going to have company. Like, there's just a lot going on. We don't need to do it all in one day. So I am writing down that Monday I'll do the cranberries and the Buckeyes. And that's really Monday or Tuesday, depending on like when all the ingredients are here and kind of how I'm feeling. You know, I may wake up tomorrow and feel worse. I may not. I don't know. We'll see. But I'm writing Monday, but really I mean Monday or Tuesday. So then for Wednesday, I'm going to go ahead and chop some of the vegetables. I know I wrote chop. I don't know why. There's actually a few spelling errors that I'm noticing because my brain was such a fog this day. Anyhow, I'm going to chop my veggies that I need for Thursday, and I'm going to make the cornbread for the cornbread stuffing dressing, and I'll make the Chex Mix, and I will make the pie, because that really probably should be made ahead. And then Thursday, I'll basically be doing everything else, but I'm writing it down anyways because I am a checklist kind of gal, and I like to cross things off. Okay, I'm setting that aside, and now I'm going to work on my grocery list. I'm basically, to make my grocery list, I'm just gonna go through each of my recipes and write down anything that I know that we don't have, and a few things that I'm pretty sure that we don't have, or that like maybe we have, but like basically I need to check in the pantry. So I actually have a lot of the ingredients on hand, which is great. There's really not a whole lot that I'm seeing that I need. Some recipes I have literally everything for. And it's good that I'm going through and making this list now, because when I got to the cream of mushroom recipe that I need for the green bean casserole, I went ahead and wrote that down on Monday on my list because that will need to get done in advance. I don't want to save that for the day of. So anyways, I wrote that, set that aside, kept just going through all of these recipes, and what I will do is text this list to Mr. Firefly so that he can get these items from the store for me, and then I will keep this list on the fridge so that I can cross things off as I have them and I know what I still need, because he'll probably end up going to a couple different stores for these things. I'll probably end up placing an order tonight of some of these groceries and having it delivered, but I know there's probably two stores he'll still go to, because the cereal I need, you can only get at one store, and the broth I need, you can only get at another store, but it's all good. It's gonna be just fine. The reason for going to so many different stores, by the way, is because we keep kosher and gluten-free. So to find certain items gluten-free and kosher, they have to come from certain stores. Not every store carries all the things gluten-free or kosher, so yeah, we kind of end up having to go all over the place, but that's okay. And then sometimes going to different stores makes a big enough of a difference financially that it is totally worth going to an additional store to get the extra items, just because the prices are crazy. All right, and there is my grocery list. It's really short this year. I am happy about that. Okay, so I'm just going to tear this page off and grab that and my other pages and take them out and put them on the fridge.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we... Okay, so now we have a plan. Plans are good. Got a grocery list to give to Mr. Firefly. I got a squirmy baby. And I have a plan so that I will not be overwhelmed this week. Okay. Okay, and with that, I will end today and I'll pick the camera back up when I'm actually cooking some of these dishes. So, see you guys in a bit. Hey friends, I am back. It is a new day. Today is Monday, and great news, I am starting to feel a lot better. Last night was pretty rough, but now we're doing better. Okay, still definitely a little foggy, a little cloudy, but I'm gonna try to get started on a little bit of the cooking today. To update on the shopping, Mr. Firefly was able to bring home a lot of the things that I needed yesterday, and then I did a Prime Now order to get a few more items. And then he's gonna pick up the last couple of things for me later today. He has to go to the kosher grocery store specifically for these items. So he will go for those as like chicken broth and stuff like that. So yeah, like kosher chicken broth, they're not gonna sell on Prime Now, but they will at our kosher grocery store. So he's gonna go get all of that stuff later. And wow, my house is like a mess right now because I was sick yesterday. So look at this, look. It's a lot of mess. So I'm gonna tackle this mess and make my kids some lunch and check back with you guys here in just a few when I will start making something. What I will be making, I don't know, but we'll make something. I'm probably gonna do cranberries today and the cream of mushroom soup. I'm so excited to make the Buckeyes, but I think I'm gonna save those till tomorrow, but I'll still film it, so don't worry. All right, let's get to it. Okay, the kitchen is reasonably clean right now. Baby Firefly has taken a nap and woken up from a nap. All the kids had a late lunch. I don't know, just been very chill because not feeling good. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is get to work on this cranberry sauce. I got my ingredients set out over here, back here behind me already. It's pretty simple. It's cranberries and sugar and water. We're not complicated here. All right, let's go make it. Cranberries are probably my favorite thing to make for Thanksgiving because they're just so darn easy and they can be made in advance. All right, what I've done so far is put in 2 cups of water and now I'm adding in 2 cups of sugar. I'm gonna give that a little stir and I've got the heat on high, trying to bring that to a boil. Okay, now that that sugar and water has reached a nice boil, I'm going to add in my cranberries. I'm using fresh cranberries and I am adding in 600 grams of cranberries. If you don't have a food scale, that is about 6 cups. Okay, you're gonna want your cranberries to sit there and simmer for about 10 minutes and you are going to want to stir occasionally. Know that your cranberries are finished because the skins have popped open and your timers have gone off. So at that point, just turn off the heat and then move your cranberries over off of the burner so that they can cool off completely before moving them into a new container and putting them in the fridge till you're ready to eat. Okay, so the cranberries are done and they just need to sit there and cool off there on the oven. Then I will move those into some kind of a container to store in the fridge until Thanksgiving. Okay, I am feeling super productive now, even if that is all that I do, and that probably is all that I am going to do. So, yeah, that's all I'm gonna do. I do, of course, reserve the right to change my mind later and come in and make the cream of mushroom soup, but for now, I might just stick with that. I'm tired, because I've been sick, so it makes sense. Okay, because I am sick, let's just call it what it is. Okay, so anyways, that's it for the moment. I may or may not be later tonight, but I mean, don't go anywhere. The video's not over yet. There's still more to do, but I may see you guys on my tomorrow. All right, anyways, that's that. See you in a bit. Hello friends, new day. Today is Tuesday and I'm losing my voice, which is awesome. That was sarcasm. Okay, so we're at IKEA right now. I wanna go inside and get a couple things for the table and just some other stuff that I need. I have not been to IKEA in what feels like forever. So this will be fun. But for Thanksgiving related stuff, I wanted to get some napkins to use for Thanksgiving because all of my cloth napkins are really just sort of falling apart at this point in time. So I have purged the cloth napkins, almost all of them, but I need more. It's time to replace them. They've all been hand-me-downs anyways. I didn't buy like any of them. So anyways, that's what we're doing here. And then we'll go home and do some more cooking. Today's schedule includes Buckeyes, yay, dessert, and cream of mushroom soup. Okay, let's go shopping. Okay, we are back from IKEA and I just want to show you guys real quick what I got for our Thanksgiving prep. All right, so I got two of these pitchers. These are, well, I'm not going to try to pronounce things. I am not. They're at IKEA if you want one. But these are just glass water pitchers. Our old pitchers I didn't really love. They didn't have like a handle. So turns out nobody in my family really loved them. But I think these are going to be much better. So I got two of these. I also restocked on candles because it's getting cold out and I'm going to be lighting candles all the time now. Plus, I will want some of these on the table while we're eating Thanksgiving. And some napkins. So I'd seen these online, but I wanted to see them in person before I got them. Oh, and now I realize there's two different kinds. Well, that's fine. They put two different patterns in the set. But that is okay. So they are like a linen cotton blend. So it's a really nice feel. I like the way that they feel. And I think these will be nice just to have on the tables. We don't have napkin rings. I see an art project coming on. All right, let's see how much cooking we can get done today. All right, let's get back to it. All right, we're gonna start off with cream of mushroom soup, which I need for the green bean casserole. We're going to need some garlic, onion, mushrooms, cornstarch, some kind of milk alternative, and olive oil. I'm going to start off by adding 2 tablespoons of olive oil to the pan, let that heat for a little bit, and then add in 1 pound of sliced fresh mushrooms, 1 large onion that I have finely chopped, and 2 garlic cloves that I have minced. So I'm just going to give that an occasional stir and let that cook. After that has cooked down, I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of salt, and if I had time, I would have added that as well, about 1/2 teaspoon, as well as 1/2 teaspoon pepper, but I didn't. And then I'm going to add in 4 cups of my milk alternative. If you don't need this to be dairy-free, you could use actual milk, but I am using soy milk from Trader Joe's instead, so 4 cups of that. And then 4 tablespoons of cornstarch, and give all of that a little stir together. Cook that for about 3 to 4 minutes, and you'll start to see that thickening up. So I just let that go at a pretty stout simmer there for a few minutes until it is as thick as I would like it, and then I just turn the heat off. I wait for it to cool completely before moving it into another container because I'm generally not using this the same day. Okay, so here is our cream of mushroom soup. I've got this jar and then one other. So I have got plenty to use for making the green bean casserole on Thursday. Okay, next thing on my list to do today was to make those Buckeyes. I'm so excited about this, y'all. I have not made Buckeyes in years. And the reason being is we couldn't find gluten-free Rice Krispies. Rice Krispies is one of those foods with a tricky little like gluten ingredient. There's malt in it, malt flavoring. That's gluten. So anyways, then we found gluten-free Rice Krispies at Walmart. I am so excited. It's like the Walmart Great Value brand Rice Krispies. So anyways, those are gluten-free. I am super stoked. So we are going to be making Buckeyes yet again today. I'm so excited. Okay, let's do this. Okay, for the Buckeyes, you're going to need some chocolate chips, peanut butter, some powdered sugar, some Rice Krispie cereal or Rice Krisps, as well as some butter or butter alternative. In a medium to large size bowl, take 3 cups of Rice Krispies cereal and 4.5 cups of powdered sugar, or 1 pound of powdered sugar, which is what I'm using here. And then mix all of that together until it's pretty well blended. Then in the stove over a double boiler, I'm using the double boiler method. You could use a microwave or, I don't know, method of your choice to melt your peanut butter, 2 cups of peanut butter and 1/2 cup of butter or butter alternative. Once that is all nicely melted, you're going to pour that over your cereal and sugar mixture. Once you've got all that poured in, just mix it all together. Even fully mixed, it's gonna still be kind of a crumbly mess like you see here in the video screen. But what you're gonna wanna do at this point is pull up a little handful and start squishing it into a ball. I make mine into about 1-inch balls, maybe slightly larger, and I got about 60 or so out of this recipe. Once those are all finished, you're gonna put those into the refrigerator so that they can chill and get nice and hard. All right, once those are done being chilled, you can melt some chocolate in your double boiler, and then you're going to drop the balls in, coat them with chocolate, and then set them over onto some wax or parchment paper so that you can put them back into the fridge where the chocolate can then harden. And I store these in the freezer or refrigerator until I am ready to eat. All right, so those Buckeyes are all finished. I used 2 bags of chocolate chips, covered as many as I could. I covered almost 40 of them in chocolate, which gives me a few of these left over. So I'm just gonna put those in the freezer and save those for another time when I just wanna make these for, at that point, a quick and easy dessert. And then the rest of these I will put into the refrigerator so that it hardens up that chocolate, and then I will move those into the freezer sometime tomorrow. All right, so that's Buckeyes. All right, that's all that I'm going to do today. I am pretty beat and exhausted right now, so I'm gonna turn off the camera, but don't go anywhere. I'll be back with the final day of Thanksgiving prep when it is tomorrow. Hello, friends. This is Future Editing Me here. Okay, I have completely lost my voice at this point in the video that I was filming. Obviously, I have it back now. It's like a week later that I'm doing this part. Oh my goodness. Anyways, that's probably really confusing because it's kind of confusing me. But anyways, see the bloopers for where I lost my voice at the end of the video, because I completely lost my voice. I was like barely a whisper and then it went away completely. But the show must go on and I still had to cook. I didn't feel bad, I just didn't have a voice. So I filmed what I was cooking and now I'm gonna come back in and talk about it and do the voiceovers to tell you what I'm doing. So, okay, let's cook. All right, so the first recipe that we're gonna be doing today is the cornbread for the cornbread stuffing that I'll be making on Thanksgiving, but I'm prepping the cornbread here today, the day before Thanksgiving. All right, if you'd like to see the full cornbread stuffing recipe, I will link to my other Thanksgiving videos below, and I do make that in previous years on Thanksgiving Day when I am filming on Thanksgiving Day. Okay, so for this cornbread, I'm just using the Trader Joe's cornbread mix, and I'm following the directions almost precisely. This is gluten-free, kosher, and dairy-free, which is perfect. I'm just going to be following the recipe here on the side of the box. So I need 1 egg, 1/2 cup of oil, I'm using avocado, and 3/4 cup of milk. And I am using this non-dairy soy beverage, also from Trader Joe's. To make this cornbread, I just take the egg and the oil and the soy milk and put that into a bowl and mix that all together. After that is mixed, add in your package of mix from the Trader Joe's cornbread mix, and then mix all of that together. It's a lot of mix. Next, after that was all mixed up, I moved it into my baking dish and then into the oven per the instructions on the package. And here it is, out of the oven and ready to eat, but I'll save it for tomorrow. Okay. The next thing that I'm going to be making is a pumpkin pie. I don't make pumpkin pie every year, but since my parents are coming to Thanksgiving this year, I wanted to make sure that I had a pumpkin pie because it's something that my dad enjoys. All right, let's make a pumpkin pie. So in order for this to be gluten-free and dairy-free, I am using this wholly gluten-free pie shell as my crust. They're pretty good. We get them at Whole Foods, and then I've got my pumpkin pie filling, of course my soy milk again, some pumpkin pie spice, and some vanilla extract. Such a simple recipe. There's also two eggs, which I forgot to show you. All right, moving right along. I literally am just gonna mix all the ingredients except for the pie crust together. So I've got one can of pumpkin, one cup of my soy milk, two eggs, one tablespoon of pumpkin pie spice, and one teaspoon of vanilla. Then I'm just going to mix all of that together, and when that is well blended, I will pour that into my pie crust. And I'm going to bake that in the oven at 450 degrees for 15 minutes. And then after that 15 minutes is up, I will reduce the heat to 350 and then bake for an additional 40 minutes. Okay, so that is all of the prep that I did for Thanksgiving on this day and on the other days getting ready to go into Thanksgiving. It was a lot of work. It was a lot of fun. It was totally worth it. We had so much fun on Thanksgiving Day. My family, of course, was all there. My extended family had come. It was a blast. It was an absolute blast. I got to see some friends later on in the day. So yeah, it was just really, really lovely. So as I said before, I did not film on Thanksgiving Day as I have in years past, but if you'd like to see the Thanksgiving Day cooking, it's pretty much the same every year. And like I said, I will link to videos below of previous Thanksgiving years, so check that out in the description. Here though is just a little snippet of kind of what the table looked like and all the food out, I guess. So here's that. All right, so that is it. That is Thanksgiving 2022. I hope that you guys all enjoyed. Thank you so much for coming along for all of this in this kind of crazy, messed up week. I feel like life is getting off the rails a lot lately, but that is just life. We just have to roll with it. So anyways, that is all that I have for you guys today. If you enjoyed, please give this video a thumbs up. I would super appreciate that. It helps my channel out a lot, so thank you. And please be sure to hit that subscribe button because I would absolutely love to see you here again. And drop me a comment down below and let me know which food item I made that you include in your Thanksgiving or just in any other time of year. And with that, we are done. I hope you all have a fabulous rest of your day, and I will see you in my next upload. I reserve the right to change my mind later and come back in and make the, what is it? I do reserve the right to change my mind. I'm shutting the camera off now. And something else. Soup, soup, soup. All right, so I got two of these pitchers. Our other water bottles. So we haven't had Rice Krispies in what feels like forever. Well, we finally found, well, thanks to a friend of ours who found them for us, but then a friend of ours. Hello and good morning. My voice is hanging on with a thread, but the cooking must continue. Okay. Oh, I really do sound bad. Okay, so, wow. Oh dear. That's not good. Hello, testing my voice. 1, 2, 3, it is a whisper. It is a whisper. Okay, friends, I am back, and there is a lot of beeping. Okay, friends, hello, and I am... Oh, tea. I filmed Thanksgiving Day. Oops. Thank you. Thank you very much.